jadedsaunders.com. Today I am here with the phenomenal musician, singer, and songwriter.
Oh, it's Tandy Jr. here.
What I'm trying to say, what I'm trying to say is I will do you You and me, you and me belong, you and me belong together. Yeah. And I believe that you, I believe you feel the same.
It was number 3 on the Urban R&B Billboard charts, is that correct? Yay. And right now it's being played on radio stations all across the country, correct? How do you feel about that?
I mean, I feel great. Mm-hmm. There's millions of people who would love to be in the position that I am. You know, I'm the new kid on the block, you know what I'm saying? There's millions of talented singer-songwriters, and I just have a great team around me. Mm-hmm. And here we are. I'm just really happy that people are digging the song, and they're playing it. It's changing my life slowly.
After you wrote the song, what space were you at that time?
I was kind of learning myself as an artist, and I was determined to make music that was kind of authentic to me. So I was just playing some keys a little bit, just vibing, you know. I was vibing with the keys, and then I just fell across this rhythm. A lot of people don't know that the song is actually a waltz, so it has this. So it kind of like, it felt like that. I was like, that's interesting. How can I make this work? I was in a very experimental stage. That's where I was. So. It worked out.
Well, I absolutely love the song. I think that it was beautifully written, beautifully composed. It seems like it represents the struggle of everyday life. It represents romantic love, and it also represents just moving forward on your path or on your journey in life. So can you just kind of share what your journey has been so far?
I come from a family of artists and musicians and stuff. So I've always been around music and the stage and all that. I've either been behind the scenes or on the stage at some point. It's always been kind of part of our everyday life. I moved to Florida, developed my relationship with my dad, and I started doing like hip-hop dancing, freestyling, and all that stuff. So just always around the stage. And then at some point, I decided I was tired of dancing around the music, figuratively and literally, you know? So I was just like, forget it, let me just chill on this. Dance and stuff, and try to write some songs. I produce for my siblings and stuff like that. So, pretty long journey. Here we are.
Here we are.
Yeah.
Well, I'm glad. So, with the song March, I just want to let you know that I'm marching with you, whether I'm behind you marching, on the side of you marching, in front of you marching, you know, back on the side. A lot of people believe that new artists just become stars pretty much overnight. Right, and their overnight successes.
I think everybody's journey is different, you know. There are some people who actually just kind of appear out of nowhere just based on association, you know what I'm saying? If you have the right connection or whatever like that, a little bit of talent, sometimes you can just get put into the spotlight, you know? Whether that's not, I guess it's based off how good your team is and the quality of the content or whatever. I don't know. But for me, it's been a very slow, a gradual, but persistent sort of journey, you know, kind of like, I believe in this music, I'm just gonna keep singing these same damn songs, and I'm gonna attract people to me, you know, that have the same type of intentions, both artistically and business-wise, and that's what happened.
So, what's like one piece of advice that someone is giving you being a brand new artist, you know, breaking into the entertainment industry?
A couple things, actually. One, keep creative control. To be authentic, like stay true, try to stay as true as possible, and a lot of stuff. Don't compare yourself to other people because it's really pointless.
Yes.
I mean, unless it's for learning, you know, we learn from each other. You learn from colleagues and stuff like that, peers. But excessively comparing myself to other people.
Well, there is no comparison. You're George Tandy.
Appreciate that.
Yeah, of course. Absolutely. what are you going to do to make sure that you stay relevant and that you potentially become an icon and a legend or a legend?
That's a great question. I really don't know. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to make the best music I can make. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to be as authentic and genuine as I can, you know, on and off stage. And then with my team, we're going to figure out ways to keep me relevant. You know, our responsibility is to just stay true, try to stay out of the drama, you know what I mean? And just make the best music I can.
And be the artist.
And be the artist. Yeah. Be the artist and try to be as aware as possible. Because I'm learning that side of the business as we speak. I just know how I'm going to conduct myself, at least try to, you know. And you see, it's kind of in the stars, you know. It's not promised. I don't think there's a formula to it. I think people decide who they're going to place up on that. You know? Yeah.
As you continue to rise and become a bigger star, how are you going to keep your feet flat on the ground and stay humble?
I'm fortunate. I have a bunch of people around, like, around me that will check me all the time. Mm-hmm. People around me won't let me start tripping out here. So, and I'm pretty spiritually grounded. I stay prayed up. I want to keep people's trust, so if I start to get too arrogant or anything like that, I'm going to lose my relationships with people, and that's pretty much what's holding this whole thing together, is the relationships that I've formed with people, in the music and around the music. So.
Who is the real George Tandy Jr.? Like, aside from music, what do you like to do in your spare time? And when you're traveling, you're on the road and all that, but what do you like to do outside of music?
I just recently started to do like kayaking and stuff. I like water sports. Apparently I like water sports. I like to chill with my pet mini dinosaur, puppy. A lot of people like to confuse him with a turtle, but he doesn't really respond well to that. You know what I'm saying?
So he's not
he's
a turtle.
He's coming out with a mixtape called These Reptiles Ain't Loyal.
Are you kidding me right now?
Anyway, yeah, I have a pet turtle. I call him mini dinosaur. Yeah. So we chill a lot. We spend a lot of time. He's actually on tour with us. I go to the movies. I read a lot. I like to chill and just laugh and be silly. I'm really silly. Like, when I'm home, I never know where I'm going to be. I really just kind of wander around.
You're a wanderer.
Yeah, I wander.
That's nice. Explore.
Yeah, I love to explore.
Are you single or taken?
I'm single.
You're single?
Yeah.
So what are the qualities that you look for in a woman?
Confidence. Kindness.
Kind.
Yeah. I like kindness, confidence, they kind of run hand in hand. Driven, you know, like passionate. Silliness, I like silliness. But I guess, you know,
just
pretty open,
cool.
Yeah, just cool. I like confidence and humble. That's cool.
That's nice. All right, so currently you're on tour, 20 cities in 30 days.
Oh, yeah.
So where are we at in the tour right now?
Right now in Oakland, and I'm loving it.
I know we're in Oakland, but I'm saying, like, are you in the middle of the tour?
I'm literal. You guys are in Oakland, and the weather is beautiful.
What's been your favorite city so far?
Oakland.
Oakland, your favorite? Yay!
So far, Oakland, like, this is just the most beautiful place in the country that I've been.
Oh, that is so sweet.
The
weather,
I really
appreciate it. What do you want your legacy to be?
Great music. Kindness.
That's it?
Great music. Yeah.
Simple. Simple. That's it.
Alright.
So your album is entitled?
The Foundation.
When does it drop?
July 29th.
Alright.
July 29th.
July 29th. And so you actually have a couple of singles. A couple of singles out right now.
Yes.
And so we can download those?
Absolutely.
Where?
On iTunes. Well, on any digital download. You know, we push iTunes. Jaded and March are both on iTunes. And actually, pre-order for the album started today.
Yay!
So I'm really excited about that.
I am too.
I could hardly sleep.
I can hardly sleep.
I was excited to let people know. So at like 11:59, I started my Instagram post.
You are off speaking of Instagram, mm-hmm. where can all your fans and future fans find you?
At Team Tandy, T-E-A-M-T-A-N-D-Y, on Twitter and Instagram, and Facebook is George Tandy Jr.
And do you have a website?
GeorgeTandyJr.com.
Everything is George Tandy Jr. No, Team Tandy.
Team Tandy.
Team Tandy.
You're Team Tandy.
I am Team Tandy.
Right?
Thank you so much. I appreciate it.
So beautiful, it's outrageous. You're so beautiful that I hate it. And it's all my fault that we faded away. What I'm trying to say, what I'm trying to say is I will do you
Everybody, George Tandy Jr. here. When you're in the Bay, holla at Cheneé. You already know.